Hello everybody, it's Gam here again from the Black Lodge, and I'm here to do another recap video. First things first, sorry I'm a bit late on this video. It's been a little while since our war ended, and we're actually a good ways into this current war against this, I think it's a South Korean clan, yep. But enough about that, let's go check out the details of our war against istanbul1453. I had some problems recording this video earlier, where I kept running out of recording space, and the video wasn't quite, I was running out of recording space. So anyway, this is like the fourth time I've recorded this, but this time it will, work. But let's get into our first replay, Conan, three-starring the number 8. This is a box space. By now, most of you probably know Conan loves to three-star these box spaces. He starts deploying loons over here to take out this air defense and to take out this archer tower. He drops this one loon for the archer tower, I think mainly to lure the clan castle, to make sure that gets lured out, because that's a key part. Next thing he's going to do is he's going to bring it down to the south here to Valk the CC. Usually the best way to take care of a CC with the least amount of troops, in most cases, is with a Valkyrie. It's something that Conan and a few other of our clan members really like to do. So now he's got all the everything bunched up other than the witch, but you can ignore the witch because the Valk can easily take care of her once everything else is gone. So in one swoop, Valk takes care of everything and then she'll kill the witch. Now let's go up top where he's deploying his heroes. Sends in three wall breakers, even though he only needs two to get through the level 9 wall, but that works out because the expo takes down one of them, so he has two left over. So good planning there to prepare for the expo. If you tried to be light and take only two wall breakers, you would have not made it through the wall. So the king takes out the defending queen and the air defense, so now everything's going great. Only two air defenses left, and he's coming in from this side, as you notice, avoiding the sweeper over here. So yeah, he's got his loons in, drops a free spell, nice free spell, getting two Teslas and an Inferno. Rage through the core, another free spell, getting two Teslas and Inferno. Good job with the spells. He saves some back-end loons here for that wizard tower to make sure the wizard tower doesn't do too much damage to any loon clumps. And then another loon for this wizard tower, but that one's mainly to distract, not so much to kill it. And then he's got about a dozen loons left, and that's going to be plenty to take care of the rest of the defenses. And now it's just clean up. So great attack, really dominated this base. Next, we're on to number 15, which was also Conan. So another 6-star war from him. He's been hot recently, as you all know. This is it's a bit of a strange, outdated base. You used to see designs like this. They're really popular. Designs similar to this, maybe about a year ago for trophy pushing. But anyway, this isn't even a good variation of that base. The CC is extremely easily lured with just one giant. And then he pulls it out to the right here. He's going to do the same thing he did on the last base and Valk the CC. And then he'll send in his heroes and clockwork the rest of the base. So let's see how he lines up all these troops here. Now he's got a bunch, so he'll drop the barb to distract, which is key, because otherwise the wizards will kill the Valk, and she won't be able to kill the wizards before they kill her. So he's just going to ignore the loon and let his heroes take care of it when it catches up. Drop some wall breakers to get into this wall. This time only brings two because he knows they're safe. So good efficiency. Giant bomb goes off, kills all his most of his barbarians, but he's fine. And now starts the rest of his raid. He doesn't even need to get an air defense. All he needs to do is get the queen and the I mean, he doesn't need to get an Inferno. All he needed to do is get the queen and the air defense, because he can bring all five spells for his loons, a freeze for each Inferno, and three rages to get the Infernos out of the way quickly. So pretty good job with this pathing there, avoiding the sweeper almost altogether. That sweeper's locked on the two balloons there. The wizard tower is distracted by the lava hound. Now the wizard tower is on the balloons. And this raid's actually a little bit of a close call here at the end with this hound popping when the balloons still have some ground left to cover, but They'll do it. These two loons here will get to the air defense before they figures out to target them. And then the ground expo goes down, and now there's just this one level 7 Tesla left, and there's about 8 or so balloons, so that's going to be plenty to take care of the rest of the base. It's a really nice raid by Conan, plenty of troops left, and with a 6 star. Next round of 4 skins raid on 16. Kind of a weird base, I think that's a level 6 air defense, which you shouldn't be seeing at downhill 10. And he's just going to lure with these hogs here, wall breakers into that wall on the bottom left there. I think he probably wanted his hogs to take out the cannon, but they didn't, but it's not going to matter. And he's going to quad hound this base. 2 witches in the CC. I don't know. I'm pretty sure he wasn't anticipating that, so puts down that minion there, which he was probably planning on using for cleanup, but instead he's going to use these minions to help power through those skeletons to help his queen beat the extra witch, on extra defending witch, because he's outmatched 1-2 on witches there. Now the king's going to come in and actually not do what he intended the king to do originally when he planned this raid, but the king actually is going to save the day here by taking out the witch, so the witch can't ruin his raid. He didn't take out the queen or any air defenses or any infernos, anything but the CC with his heroes and his opener. But because this is an awful base, that's not going to matter. I think he probably wanted to freeze both infernos there too, but he missed on the first one. So just not a very good base, but still a good job by Foreskins to pull through and not let the things that didn't go his way distract him or make him panic. It was very cool, calm, and collected when the hogs didn't kill the cannon and when his heroes couldn't take care of the witch and the way he planned. And he even has a hound pop there just as the last defense goes down to help him with some cleanup. So, good lesson on how not to panic when things don't go your way, and a good lesson on how to improvise and recover and still come out with 3 stars. So good job. Next, we're on to Rezzy's raid on 17. Again, not a great layout. Kind of looks like weird looking base. Anyway, he's going to jump into this compartment here with the low-level walls. He's not going to risk trying to wall breaker and possibly mess something up. So he sends in his heroes. His golems are punching the wizard tower. Enemy queen's already down. Some pretty low-level defenses on this base, so the king's going to be able to do a ton of work, and so are the golems and his queen. In a minute, he'll rage his king here, I think, and his king's going to take out, like, half the bottom of this base. Well, his queen and his golems go up north to take care of the CC, which he lightninged, and this inferno tower and that air defense. So after this queen takes care of the gold storage, she'll lock onto the inferno tower, and then he'll start the main portion of his raid. He's going to come in from 12 o'clock and finish at 6 o'clock so that he can avoid the sweeper, which is pointed in that direction. So his loons come in, a lot of loons for one archer tower there, but it's not going to matter because he's going to use those loons to pass to the inferno. They all clump up a little bit here, but luckily some of them do split off onto that expo. Nice free spell gets the inferno and the air defense. That's always a good, nice valued freeze when you can get both of those defenses in one. Now loons head to the sweeper, head to the Teslas. Wizard tower's locked onto a big clump of loons there, does some damage. Air bomb goes off on nothing, which is fortunate for him, and now the wizard tower goes down. Tesla goes down, and then the last Tesla will go down. So he had a hound live through this raid. That hit a balloon. So yeah, he did have a hound live through the raid, which shows he really bullied this base. Outcome was never really in question, even though he didn't have too many loons left. But he didn't even need all the hit points from his hounds to get through the base, so whenever that happens, you know you're in the clear unless you can't don't have enough cleanup. But he did, so he 3-starred. So good job, Rezzy. Next, run 18, and this is actually a really awesome attack here. As you can tell by the troops at the bottom, this is a Town Hall 9 attacking this Town Hall 10. And this is actually a pretty high-level Town Hall 10 for a Town Hall 9 to be 3-starring. It's got two multi-target Infernos. It's got 20-20 heroes. It's got all three Expos built. Town Hall max, Town Hall 9 max for every defense other than that Archer Tower there, I think, as well. And the cannon at the top. So, really ridiculously awesome raid from Keo here. Anyway, he's going to start the raid over here up top by using a balloon to take care of that baby cannon and to lure the Klein Castle. He's bringing two witches of his own to drop to kill the defending CC. Luckily for him, there weren't two witches in the clan castle, so his two witches should be plenty to take care of the rest of the defending clan castle. He starts over here, puts down a bunch of wizards to funnel, and a golem, and his queen. And he's going to be trying to get into this compartment to take care of the queen and the inferno, the leftmost inferno. And so his queen's doing well. The funnel's completed, nowhere for his king to get distracted, which is good. Now his king's in, he'll probably rage his king soon to take care of the queen. A really good jump spell there, it spans 1, 2, 3, 4 different compartments, which is always something you like to see. He starts with his hogs on the back end here, an Asian deployment to get them all down, and a rage now to get them to the inferno. And as soon as the inferno goes down, or a little bit before, drops a heal so that the second that Inferno goes down, the hogs can get healed up because they'll no longer be having the heal canceled. He sees the giant bomb go off there, so he quick drops a heal and he drops it in time. His hogs get healed up nicely. Saves a back end loon here and another one he used over on the right there. Some mini bombs, and I think there's actually a giant bomb here. No, it's just a bunch more mini bombs. Okay, so his hogs are pretty low now. But all that's left is a mortar, and a mortar can't hurt loons, and it can't really hurt hogs much either. So at this point, he's got it. His balloon helps out with the little skeletons harassing the hogs. As you can see, both of his heroes lived, which is just ridiculous. He's still got the original two witches over on the side here, and all the skeletons helping clean up, and his cleanup goblin, and two loons, and four or so hogs. So to really run over a Town Hall 10 with not an awful layout and at least Town Hall 9 max everything as a Town Hall 9 is really impressive. So way to go for Keo. One of the better raids I've ever seen, actually. Next were last Town Hall 10 3-star, which is my raid. My first raid was on the number 3 and I didn't go to plan. I failed it a little bit for 3-stars. So I kind of took revenge on their lowest 10 because I wanted to get a sure 3-star. So I did this attack about 30 seconds after my first attack without really planning. I just cooked up a Penta army and a couple wall breakers. And as you can see, I started my my air part of the raid. I was really just using my queen to distract the enemy CC more than kill it. Just buy some time until the pups are up. The hero's really only purpose was just to kill the defending queen. Since this was such a low-level base with a poor layout, it didn't matter really what I did. So yeah, all the air defenses are down. Only really threatening thing left is the wizard towers. I still have two hounds alive, and they'll live through the whole raid. So yeah, I probably could have brought one less hound and a few more loons if I wanted it a little tidier, because I think I only had three loons live. Been really embarrassing if I didn't 3-star this raid with two hounds left and no loons. So, but that didn't happen, so it was still a 3-star, so I got the job done, even though it was only an 80k weight, which is ridiculously low. Now we're going to show the top 3 Town Hall 9 raids. We didn't have any other interesting Town Hall 9 on Town Hall 10 raids that I can remember, so nothing to show there. But we're going to have BA with a nice surgical hog raid here. He's bringing two golems and some wizards and his heroes, and he's going to put all those through to the center of the base. and they're going to take care of the core. This is a pretty poor base design where it has all four giant bombs in the core. I think there's one here, or two here, and then two here. So yeah, he's going to send his golems in there and his heroes so that they can take care of that danger so the hogs won't have to deal with it. Defending queen's already down. Everything's going beautifully to the core. Pretty weak base design, as in this open area to walk in the core here. If you just put those walls so that you couldn't just walk into the core from that compartment, it'd be a much, well, maybe not a much stronger base, but would be a better base for sure. Anyway, he's putting his hogs, three or four on every defense, like you do. Golem's still alive in the core. Queen's still alive in the core. He's going to use two back-end loons on that cannon there, and his last two hogs are down to take care of the last archer towers. Only one giant bomb is triggered on the hogs. That one goes off on one solo archer. Yeah, he's got like 12 hogs left, two golemites, his queen, a bunch of wizards, even both of the giants that he used to, or just even one of the giants he used to tank for his hogs is still alive, so great raid by BA. Next round to Ruben. Ruben's going to do a nice air raid here, go lava loon. About this base, I actually, this was the last time I had to raid a Town Hall 9. This is the base I had to raid. It was a few months ago, last time I had to dip on a 9. And it was this design. I think I just pented it from north to south. But anyway, we're going to see Ruben take a little bit more elegant solution to 3-starring this base as a Town Hall 9. Yeah, he lightnings the claim castle, gets the witch and everything. His king's going to go south and his queen's going to go north, so he's going to get two air defenses. I don't think he expected to get two air defenses, but he does get two air defenses, so good job there. And then his king will take out that wizard tower there. And he sends in loons here. So he only, pause, he drops one balloon here and two there. I'm almost 100% sure he meant to drop two and two, but instead accidentally dropped one and one, and we'll see how that affects this raid later. So there comes in his lava hound. CC1's already dead. No, that's the CC1 there, I think. And then his other one is down, so yep. And he has one balloon left over, which I believe was the balloon he meant to drop on the right. But he's going to use that balloon to sneak up on this mortar and then sneak up on the sweeper and save his raid. Because right now he's got all four Teslas to take on. Does have two hounds left, but one's about to go down here, and then the other one is pretty low in health. And then these last three loons from the bottom come in and try to save the day. Last hound is down. There were still two Teslas up there. Still one up. So if that sweeper wasn't ambushed by that balloon there, it might not have been a 3-star. The Tesla might have ruined the raid. So he actually might have lucked out that he didn't do the proper loon drops that he intended. So yeah, interesting. Anyway, he's got enough loons and pups left to clean up the rest of the base. And it's going to be a pretty nice 3-star from Ruben, so way to go. Now on to our last Town Hall 9 attack by Sooth Flare. Interesting raid here. It's actually kind of a go-wee-ho raid, more than just a go-ho, or a surgical hog, or a CB or whatever, or shattered, because he brings, as you can see, three witches. He's going to use them a little interestingly. He's going to take care of the CC over here with his witches. And then what I would have done is I would have gone in from this top here to take out his two defending heroes right away. But instead, he's going to come through on the right side with all three witches backing up the golems and heroes. And he's going to take care of like half of this base with just his heroes, three witches, a rage spell, and two golems, and a couple wizards to funnel. So... and a jump spell. So a really cool raid from him here, and it was enabled by the ability to easily lure the CC with just one giant for the town hall centered instead of the clan castle. So now his king goes down. No funny business with the king. He made sure to funnel really, really wide. No risk of his king wandering. Now his troops are all going to ignore the defending queen, which I think was actually his intention. Now he's got his heroes in the core. He's got both abilities left. He started his hogs on the bottom side here, healing through a giant bomb, healing through another one. His hog's actually helping in the core now. Now his queen comes out, still has her ability, and the queen's finally going to figure out there's a other defending queen she needs to kill, and finally do that here. So now the defending queen's out of the way, giant bomb goes off, but it's no problem because they're in a heal for most of it. And now there's just the defending king left, really, and these two defenses, and the queen, and these witches are all still alive. So all three of his witches that he used to kill the clan castle lived through the raid and really are what propelled him to victory here. So interesting thing, if you're a Town Hall 9 and you can lure the CC easily, might be something to try in your next raid. Anyways, now we're going to quickly jump over to our current war because I didn't get this video done in time, so we're already a few hours, 8 hours or so into this war. We've already used more than half our attacks. As you can see, we're off to a pretty good start. We have got the one Town Hall 10 3 star so far. 16 might be one too. No. No, yeah, it is Poco with a Town Hall 9 3 star on a Town Hall 10. So you guys can look forward to that one next for the next recap, which should be up later today. One more thing, is it still in my defense log? No, it wasn't. Anyway, this guy dropped three lightning spells on me on my dark elixir storage when this is the farm base I have. So yeah, that was pretty interesting. And he had plenty of troops, so I don't know what's wrong with him, but he's an idiot. So shame I couldn't get this video out earlier, otherwise I could have shown that. Oh, tree. Cool. Anyway, I'm gonna get this uploaded and then I'm gonna go and record an episode on my mini, my other series. So if you haven't seen the first episode of that series, go check it out maybe if you're interested in seeing some more videos. And anyway, I'll get back to you with the recap of our current war soon. See you guys next time. And thanks for watching.